Okay, there was another type of COBOL program that's very rarely used. It was a sort program that uses a special command called sort. And I believe that it was started in the beginning to sort files, right? That was before the creation of a sort utility. But after the sort utility was created on the IBM mainframe, it was more efficient than COBOL sort commands. So places where I worked, we were told not to use the sort statement. Also, the sort statement was kind of confusing to use, but you might see a sort program, so I'll show you how it works. You define three files: the input file, this is the input file here for example, the sort work file, which is a temporary file that's created when the program runs and is destroyed when the program ends, and the sort output file, right? So input is a permanent file, right? Output is a permanent output file that's created by the program, right? So the input and the output have a normal FD file definition statement. So in our example, the files are 80 characters wide, right? You can see that there. And then the sort work file is a special file. It has an SD instead of a FD for sort definition, right? And it defines the fields that are going to be used for sorting, right? In my example, I have two fields called sort1 and sort2. And then in the procedure division, the simplest example is to just have one statement in your procedure division that says sort work on ascending key such and such. And then if you have two keys, you can say this, right? Using sort in, giving sort out, right? Actually, you would have to have a stop run after that. But, well, if your program came to the end of the lines, then it would stop anyways, right? But you didn't have to have an open input file net sort in or an open output sort out command, because this sort statement will do that automatically. It'll open the sort in file, it'll sort everything using the sort work area, and then it'll write the output to the sort out file, right? Very powerful command, but very difficult to understand. This is a simple version. That's kind of simple to understand, but here's the more complicated form, right? More complicated form is you specify an input procedure and an output procedure, right? Input procedure is done to do processing on the input file, and the output procedure is done to do processing on the output file, right? And these are normally the names of sections, right? A section looks like a paragraph, but it actually means more than one paragraph. A section begins where you see the word section, and it ends where you see the next section begin. Right, so for example, for a sort in section, you would say return, which means read the record into the sort work area. At end, go to 199. Exit means when you've read all of the records, then exit the section. Right, and then in the middle, you would have whatever processing you wanted to do. Like for example, if you wanted to change all spaces to zeros, right, you would write commands to do that. Right, then sort out section, similarly, it's a section, right? It'll end when it sees another section or when the program comes to an end, right? And there, at the end of the section, you would have a command, release sort work, right? Which means put the output record into the output file, right? And in between, you would have whatever commands you wanted to do, right? Like if you wanted to change all uppercase characters to lowercase characters, then you would have code in here to do that, right? Let me do an example. If, like, suppose there's some variable called xx, then if it equals a, then move little a to xx, right? Or whatever, right? It's basically some kind of special processing that you might want to do. But like I say, it becomes so complicated and so difficult to follow what's going on that most shops banned the sort statement. It's only like the really old programs that were written many decades ago before that rule came out that would actually use the sort statement. So that's the lesson.